Hello, and welcome to the A10 Network CGN webinar. In this session, we will discuss how A10 CGN solutions will help extend IPv4 connectivity and provide broad transitions of options to IPv6. A couple of things you need to know during this webinar are there is a chat window on the top left of your screen for a Q&A dialogue, as we will have a live Q&A session at the end of the webinar. So please make sure you stick around for that. There is also a resource window on the right side of your screen where you will find more information about A10 networks and our solutions, including materials to review such as white papers and solution briefs about this webinar topic. Now please let me introduce our speakers, our principal solution architect, Gennady Dosovitsky, and to start us off, our senior product marketing manager, Lakshmi Kandadai.
Thanks, Shanna, for the introduction. Good morning, everyone, and thanks for joining our webinar today. As Shanna mentioned, we will be focusing today's session on carrier-grade networking solutions from A10 and how we can help service providers and enterprises with the IPv4 exhaustion challenge and help them secure a path towards IPv6. Let's start with some of the market trends and disruptors. Service providers have long been experiencing dramatic increase in the number of devices, the number of users getting connected to the internet, and that subsequently means the total consumer IP traffic is exploding, and it is predicted to grow threefold from 2015 towards 2020. And that means a challenge, especially with the IPv4 exhaustion that's happening right now. As far as IPv6 is concerned, we have been seeing dramatic increase in the adoption rates for IPv6, starting from less than 2% in 2013 and growing towards 18% in 2017. And these are the statistics that I pulled in from Google that shows percentage of users who access Google via IPv6. And that's one statistic. That's an indication of how rapidly the IPv6 adoption is being adopted. And last but not the least, we have been seeing a lot of increase in the number of connected devices, be it smart home, or be it machine-to-machine services and IoT services that are being provided by service providers or mobile carriers in order to stay competitive and to create more revenue-generating services. And we see that anywhere between 30 billion to 50 billion units will be connected by 2020. And these are the predictions by industry-leading vendors such as Cisco, Ericsson, so on and so forth. What does this mean for a service provider? It means helping them move from a triple play towards quad play and multi-play services. And in terms of enterprises, it is basically dealing with bring your own device challenge and its enormous security implications. In terms of IoT, as we talk about, as we just discussed, it's all about wearables, home automation, industrial, and machine-to-machine communications. So simply put, more users, more devices, and more applications. What is the challenge that it brings to service providers and enterprises? The immediate challenge is to overcome the rapidly diminishing IPv4 address space. As we all know, we have completely exhausted our IPv4 space, and the last subnet has been handed out somewhere towards the end of 2016. And service providers have to overcome this challenge and have to deliver seamless subscriber experience in order to reduce the risk of losing business continuity and brand credibility. So these are some of the immediate challenges that have to be tackled. Of course, there are challenges that come as a next phase. That is to assure sustainable subscriber growth by moving on towards IPv6 networks and making that transition. And all with a secure environment for subscribers and enterprises. and always-on experience with the lower total cost of ownership. So this is what a service provider and an enterprise would ideally dream of. So what do they need? Service providers and enterprises need these four key features that comprises part of a carrier-grade networking solution. The first one would be to extend life of IPv4 network infrastructure to tackle that immediate challenge. And while you make that transition towards your IPv6, and the devices, the infrastructure, and subscribers have to be safe. So we need an integrated DDoS security mechanism to not only protect the device, but also subscribers, enterprise hosts, and services around it. And of course, the subscriber and application awareness is key, because in order to provide a more customized policy towards subscribers, this type of awareness is essential. Some of the challenges with conventional CGN solutions has always been around limited performance and scale. We have seen a lot of router-based and chassis-based solutions offering CGNAT solutions, but they lack in terms of the number of sessions that they are able to support and subsequently the subscriber scale. So each line card that provides the carrier-grade networking solution gets immediately fixed with the number of subscribers that it is able to handle. And these router-based solutions are really optimized for layer 2 to layer 3 services and not for layer 4 to 7 service flows. Of course, in terms of redundancy, when we have inter and intra chassis-based mechanism, redundancy solutions are really weak. In terms of the limited feature set capability, a lot of conventional solutions lack integrated DDoS security to protect the appliance itself from an attack. And we have seen that several solutions out there either just offer CGNAT or they lack the need and mechanism to support mobile network providers like a GI, SGI LAN service for service provider and mobile network deployments. In terms of platform extensibility, we have seen that these conventional CGN solutions are really inflexible and they force the operator to go to a different chassis when they exceed 300 gigs, for example, right? It's really inflexible to have big chassis-based solutions, of course, with large data center footprint and high TCO. So with these challenges, let's showcase what ATEN Thunder CGN brings to you. The Thunder CGN product line of carrier-grade networking gateways provides high-performance and highly transparent protocol translation and protocol and address translation. To scale your infrastructure to perform millions of IPv4 to V6 address translations, both by extending the IPv4 network connectivity and providing comprehensive IPv6 migration techniques. I would also like to take this opportunity to let you know that we have recently been awarded Interop Japan's award for our impressive performance and session scalability that our product line brings, our carrier-grade networking product line brings, for carrier and ISP networking category. So the CGNAT solutions from ATEN really has that performance scalability and will be able to help you to move your, to plan your transition towards IPv6. These are some of the numbers that we really wanted to highlight. Not only including the comprehensive feature set that comes with the CGNAT product, including the standardized CGNAT functions such as NAT44 and 444, and all IPv6 migration techniques along with the built-in DDoS protection, the performance number, when you look at the performance and scalability, the CGN solution from ATEN delivers the performance scalability that you need up to 256 million concurrent sessions and up to 220 gigs of throughput all in one rack unit. And that is the best that we have seen so far, considering the data center footprint that the CGN appliance occupies. That's lower TCO by reducing the power consumption that it needs. And you can also cluster CGN appliances to up to 8 CGN appliances to cluster over 1.7 terabits of throughput. We offer flexible form factors to match any of your deployment needs, either with physical hardware appliance or software form factors such as virtual and bare metal for COTS hardware. You can pick your own COTS hardware and leverage A10 CGN for bare metal and reduce your total cost of ownership of the entire solution. In terms of visibility, we support S-Flow and NetFlow to allow service providers to collect and analyze traffic data that is essential in order to perform capacity planning and monitoring capabilities. We also support syslog and ceph logging formats for comprehensive CGNAT logging. Okay, we talked about the A10 CGN capabilities that it provides. But having said that, it is not really practical for a service provider to perform the transition from IPv4 to V6 overnight. It takes years of planning, and a total switchover is impractical because the number of hosts that are involved and the number of organizations like content providers, when they have these content on IPv4-based servers or IPv6-based, and these device manufacturers have also to embrace IPv6 and need to provide the dual stack option, making that device compatible for IPv4 and V6 versions. So having said that, the best solution for any given organization varies depending on their existing infrastructure, the time frame, and the total capex that an organization is ready to put in to migrate to IPv6. A10 offers you the flexibility to go with your choice of any access core network. It can be IPv6 or V4. We have several IPv6 migration solutions such as NAT64, DNS64, or we also offer IPv6 rapid deployment, that is 6RD, and DS Lite, or Lightweight 4/6, and MAP technologies, like mapping of address and port translation support. You can pick and choose depending on whatever your infrastructure is built on, and you can trust us as your trusted partner for your entire IPv6 transition lifecycle. I just wanted to highlight our CGN product portfolio. We discussed about the form factors. We have Thunder Appliance, that is the hardware appliances from A10. And we also have the Thunder SPE appliance, which has which leverages a special security and policy engine to deliver ultra-high speed security and policy enforcement. And you can leverage Thunder SPE appliance for CGN to go up to 300 gigs of throughput. We have software options available on bare metal, so you can leverage your COTS hardware and have your bare metal software installed, deployed as an ISO image or Pixie deployment. You also have virtual form factors, vThunder CGN, available on industry-leading, supporting industry-leading hypervisors such as VMware, Hyper-V, and KVM. We also support DPDK and SRIOV for performance enhancements. You can spin up and spin down these virtual CGN instances on demand by leveraging our SDN NFV support. We will cover that later in the upcoming slides. Just to showcase the Thunder CGN feature set, We talked about standardized NAT support, that is basically NAT 4.4 and NAT 4.4.4. CGNAT was really created to standardize the NAT functions and behavior between different network vendors. We offer properties such as stickiness, that means end users that are NATed with an IP address will have all subsequent flows NATed with the same IP addresses. Fairness, we make sure that all users are guaranteed to have the NAT resources reserved for their needs. We also offer hairpinning and endpoint independent mapping and filtering to provide transparent NAT for your subscribers. All these features are provided with A10 CGN solutions to provide seamless user experience to your subscribers. In terms of IPv6 migration, as I mentioned before, we offer comprehensive IPv6 migration techniques such as 6RD or IPv6 rapid deployment to enable IPv6 clients access IPv6 internet over an IPv4 core. So this is one example where you can leverage V6 transition technique. You can also have NAT 6.4 and DNS 6.4. So basically these are several IPv6 migration techniques. It really depends on what your infrastructure currently is built on and how we can how you can leverage these support from A10 CGN solutions. We offer transition tunneling and interplay between IPv4 and V6 networks. Mainly, these protocol support, they can run concurrently on the same CGN device to make sure that your end users, regardless of the version of the IP that their devices are using, will get access to the content that they need to access over any core. It can be IPv4 or V6 core network. We also ensure that the IPv6 clients would get access to IPv4 content via tunneling techniques. DDoS. We have all heard about DDoS attacks, distributed denial of service attacks. These multi-vector DDoS attacks are getting bigger, smarter, and more devastating. We all have heard about Mirai botnet attack that has primarily compromised internet-connected DVRs and surveillance cameras. So it is really important to protect the device and the NAT IP pools from such a DDoS attack in order to make sure that your services are uninterrupted. So there are three ways we look at when we say integrated DDoS protection with CGNAT devices. Self-protecting the device is the primary capability because the device has to stay, it has to be able to survive a DDoS attack in order to protect all the subscribers from that NAT pool. And we can also have attacks from outside, that is from an traffic towards internal hosts and services, and attacks from inside, that is traffic towards a specific compromised host. Whatever be the attack, we offer techniques such as connection rate limiting, selective dynamic filtering, IP anomaly detection, and per user granularity. So these are some of the techniques that we offer to not only protect the CGNAT appliance from a DDoS attack, but also the subscribers and the enterprise services and hosts in your network. And this is really key in order to maintain service availability and business continuity. Application integrity. Not all applications survive the NAT traversals. Applications such as Skype, gaming, and other functionality would eventually break when they go through the NAT traversals because they have certain control and data plane IP and port information in their payload, and the NAT traversals would compromise that information. and the IP addresses won't match. It tends to break these applications. But some application layer gateways are really essential in order to make sure that the applications are available and reachable even after going through several levels of NATing. It can be NAT 4.4, that is one level of NAT, or NAT 4.4.4, that is multiple levels of NAT. ATEM CGN solutions provide necessary visibility into the packet payload and make sure that all the protocols that carries IP information in their payload remain functional even after the NATing process. We offer ALG support for protocols such as Media Control Gateway Protocol or SIP, that is primarily used for IMS-based applications, real-time streaming protocol for video and media applications. So these are some of the protocols that has been listed, but we do offer a comprehensive list of ALG support along with our CGNAT product line. Ease of use and management. All of our devices can be either managed via a graphical interface, such as this, where it is easy to manage the device by logging in through this GUI, or they can either, so the service providers can either use a command line interface, such as this particular GUI. This is basically industry standard CLI. It's a familiar interface and easy to use for service providers to perform their, to manage the device and perform the management functionality. And we also offer policy management through AX APIs and AFLEX APIs in order to control and program your device, CGNAT device, for much needed visibility. And we have our A-Galaxy centralized management to manage all your CGNAT devices in your infrastructure. Logging capability. Federal government usually mandates service providers with an ability to trace any user's connection history in any point in time. So it is essential for the service providers and enterprises to make sure that the CGNAT devices come with comprehensive logging and are able to comply with law enforcement agency compliance. ATEM CGNAT provides comprehensive logging support. We support protocols such as syslog, CEF formats, and we also have provide techniques such as deterministic NAT in order to dramatically minimize or reduce the logging volume, or also eliminate the need for logging altogether. We can so you can basically trace the connection by using an algorithmic method of detecting the log. So along with high-speed logging, we also provide high availability for your CGNAT operations through stateful session synchronization. We make sure that the sessions that are active remain active even during your failover. If there is a failover of one of the devices, we make sure that all the active sessions get carried on to the standby CGNAT device. I wanted to take this moment to describe what we call as application delivery partitions for layer 3 virtualization. You can leverage ADPs for partitioning your device. We support up to 1023, that is 1023 ADP partitions on a single device, on a single CGN, to offer you the flexibility to deploy either ADP or CGN. The basic functionality or the business benefit that it provides is multi-tenancy, as well as operational simplification and accelerated rollout. You don't need to wait for the CGN appliances to get shipped to your data center. you can immediately start, if you have an 810 CG an appliance, you can use ADP to leverage. If you are using it for your load balancing purpose, you can repurpose it for your CGN needs, career grade networking needs. And since that will be a single vendor solution, any troubleshooting that needs to be done, it is made easier. And we also, you can also reduce total cost of ownership by reducing the spares that you need in your environment. So that's the value and flexibility that ADP brings. With the flexibility that allows you to deploy ADC or CGN. When it comes to a mobile service provider environment, let me just give you a brief quick overview on the GI interface. So the traffic coming in from these devices to your left, those are the mobile and IoT devices, all get aggregated at an aggregation router on the radio access network, and they get transported over through the Evolve packet core and through the GI LAN. So the GI LAN is basically an interface between the Evolve packet core. It's a traditional IP interface between the Evolve packet core and the internet. And it is primarily left open because operators can leverage, perform deep packet inspection, and perform service chaining or for business agility and innovative services in the flow. Since this interface is left open, it is susceptible to any kind of attack. It can be a DOS attack or a DDoS attack. So it is really essential for mobile service providers to protect that interface from such an attack. And that is usually the place where the CGNAT device is usually sits in the mobile network. The CGN device with the GI or SGI firewall functionality, along with integrated DDoS protection, can be leveraged for this purpose. We offer large concurrent sessions and throughput scale with our GI firewall with integrated CGNAT, especially tailor-made for mobile service providers. And that is usually the device that protects, not only protects the mobile core infrastructure, that's the Evolve packet core infrastructure, it can be S-Gateway or P-Gateway, GGSN or SGSN, anything that sits in the Evolve packet core, and also the subscribers from a DDoS attack. So this is a GI, SGI firewall with integrated CGNAT capability for your purpose. Coming to SDN and NFV, this is one of the innovations that has been happening for quite some time now in a mobile service provider industry. It is really key for operators to build a foundation based on any open platform, primarily to avoid vendor lock-in and to provide or to enable greater innovation. 810 CGN devices, career-grade networking appliances, are well integrated with cloud frameworks such as OpenStack. And we are also integrated with industry-leading Nano orchestrators. We recently did an HC NFV plug test, and we are integrated with leading management and orchestration providers, as well as the SDN fabric, in order to provide you as a cloud service provider to dynamically provision your layer 4 to layer 7 services on demand. That means you don't have to over-provision your network for the worst-case scenario. You can essentially use the SDN NFV support to, with our flexible form factors, we offer vThunder-based CGNAT or bare metal-based CGNAT, and on-demand licensing. This is the flexible licensing policy that we offer. It can be subscription-based or capacity-based, to make sure that you as a service provider have that needed business agility, and you can provision your revenue generating services on demand. moving on to use cases. So these are some of the features and differentiators that A10 CGNAT brings to the service providers and enterprises. I want to quickly move on to some of the use cases that I find that we find interesting. For example, ADC and CGN can be used for offering load balancing services to SPR AAA or radius load balancing, along with CGNAT functionality for a use case such as stadium wireless offload. Right, these devices that are getting authenticated would basically leverage A10 hardware appliance or virtualized appliance, vThunder CGN or vThunder ADC, to perform authentication by sending the radius messages towards these AAA servers in your data center to perform load balancing, as well as perform carrier-grade network address translation for all the subscribers for their IP addresses. So this is one of the use cases that you can use A10 Thunder CGN along with ADC. You can use leverage application delivery partitions for this purpose. The other use case that we find interesting and that primarily is applicable to IoT services, if you as a service provider are offering IoT services or even enabling any of your customer to provide IoT utility services, one of an interesting use case that we have seen in the past is providing access towards IPv6 only endpoints to IPv4 or V6 server nodes over an IPv4 network. So it's basically it basically depends on what the core network is and what your end devices are. We provide you with comprehensive support. We can also you can also leverage our devices A10 solutions for 6-in-4 tunneling, for example, over IPsec, in order to transport all your IPv6-based devices traffic over an IPv4 cloud. So this is an interesting use case that we think that might help you as a service provider if you are offering this type of service to your enterprise customers. Okay, let's move on to case study, a real world case study where we were able to win the A10 Thunder CGN deal. This is the case study based on one of our key wins. The service provider was one of the largest mobile network operators in Asia. The business profile, it's basically the service provider was offering tens and millions of smartphone subscribers. They were offering quad play services, voice, broadband, IPTV, and mobile all together. And some of the challenges that they had was they were preparing for an 5G services launch, and they had so many IPv6 devices and so many IPv6 content servers, and they wanted to provide a reliable and future-proof IPv6 migration solutions. And the primary requirement was higher NAT session capacity in order to provide services towards tens and millions of subscribers that they support. And we were able to meet and exceed the RFP requirements for high availability session sync. There were a lot of other factors as well why we were chosen, but some of the key features that I wanted to highlight during today's session is high availability session sync. A10 Thunder CGN can be deployed in high availability mode, and we make sure that the active sessions do carry over even during a failover. We provide superior NAT session logging and ALG support that the prospective customer needed. And during the POC, the A10 Thunder CGN box or appliance or solution was able to provide superior performance versus two leading competitors. We were able to support the customer with a dynamic deep packet buffer for the microbus traffic flows that was tested during the POC. And the CGN solution was able to support advanced CPS, that is connections per second, and concurrent connections with lower CPU utilization. It was around 20 to 30% lower CPU utilization compared to the competitors. And of course, with our all-inclusive license, we don't charge anything, no extra add-ons license cost for the extra feature that you need. All the features that come with the CGN appliance are included in the license. So the all-inclusive license and the converged functionality provides you a lower TCO. And this particular customer was able to achieve 30% OPEX reduction with A10 CGN solution. And this was one of the case studies that was quite interesting, and I wanted to share this with you. Just to wrap up, these are the key features that make customers choose A10. We offer best-in-class performance along with superior scalability. You can use our scale-up and down or scale-in and out functionality to provision your the needed functionality on demand. Proven carrier-grade networking, security, CGN, security and networking features. All-inclusive licensing and support for predictable total cost of ownership. Flexible virtualization. We offer vThunder CGN, and we are one of the unique vendors offering bare metal for CGN for higher performance. Efficient design, reduced data center footprint. And we provide you with the needed visibility for, just as I discussed before, S-flow, NetFlow, syslog, SEP format logging. We provide you with that needed visibility for your capacity planning purposes. So these are some of the reasons why customers chose A10 for their CGN solutions, and I hope you will too. If you have any questions, please talk to us so we can help you with your IPv4 to V6 transition.
Okay, thank you, Lakshmi. Now we will be taking questions. To submit a question, please go to the chat window on the top left side of your screen for Q&A dialogue. Our first question is a question on DDoS functionality. What do we do when we see a volumetric attack like DDoS? Do we take action and start dropping the packets or work with the BGP community?
When there is a DDoS attack, such as a volumetric attack, for example, we first log the attack with our superior logging capability, or we drop the packets, or even signal upstream routers with remotely triggered black hole functionality. So the upstream routers can take an action on what to do with the packet. They can null the route or redirect it to a scrubbing center, for example, for the attack scrubbing, and make sure that only the clean traffic passes through the network. I hope it answered your question.
Thank you. With many carrier-grade networking options available, what would be the best migration strategy for mobile service providers?
Okay, this is, this is basically a question that a lot of mobile service providers have. It really depends on what the organization, what the network strategy is and the long-term vision of that organization is. There is no, there is not a single solution that that can really help. But we offer A10 CGN solutions offer the best comprehensive IPv6 migration support. For example, one of the techniques that the mobile service providers can do is they take care of that IPv4 exhaustion with CGNAT, NAT44 or 444, to simply extend the life of their IPv4 infrastructure. But this would lead to an increased OPEX because all traffic has to be CGNATed, right? The other approach can be a dual stack approach. Both support IPv4 and V6 together. But usually this is less desirable because of the complexity involved in deploying and managing the dual stack network. Basically, IP address has to be managed. IP address management, ITAM, has to be done for both V4 and V6 networks. There is other option to go only with IPv6. This is not desirable because there are still lots of devices that are IPv4 only. For example, cable service providers, they have their home modems that are IPv4 only capable, and if the service provider go with IPv6 only network, then they have to basically upgrade all their home modems to IPv6. That's a costly upgrade. So one of the proven techniques that we help some of our mobile subscribers, mobile service providers with, is IPv4 only plus 464xlat technique. Basically, IPv6 devices get access to IPv6 content because the core network is IPv6. And for IPv4 devices, we basically apply 464xlat, that is stateless translation, NAT46, that is done at the customer side, plus stateful translation, NAT64, that is done at the provider side. It's basically CLAT plus PLAT together. So, it's, so to answer your question, please talk to us regarding your organization's network strategy, and we can help you with the right migration technique for your needs. And we have helped several mobile service providers with their complete transition lifecycle.
Great, thank you. It looks like we only have one more question. So if you do have questions, please make sure that you submit them in the Q&A chat window. The last question that is showing right now is, how can a service provider prevent their own subscribers to flood their backbone and avoid getting their SP's public IP blacklisted?
Okay. We have basically, so when a compromised subscriber tries in a service provider network tries to initiate a DDoS kind of an attack, they can leverage the A10 CGN solution. So we basically have the built-in DDoS protection technique to protect our NAT IP addresses and make sure that all subscribers behind that NAT pool do get service continuity. And we can apply packet rate limiting, or we can also control the outbound bus from these subscribers. So outbound rate limiting or packet rate limiting can be applied to these external IPs. We also can, for the bandwidth limitation, we can use our QoS mechanism, traffic marking and signaling to external devices. So you can have several of these techniques, but again, it's really a specific question, so please talk to us and we can help you with this situation.
Okay, great. It looks like we have another question coming in. What kind of traffic growth rates are you seeing in your customer base? What do we need to plan for?
Well, this is really a generic question. It kind of it really depends on what the service provider has been seeing in their network. And as I mentioned before, there are lots of devices, especially from a mobile service provider scenario. We have been seeing millions of subscribers being added towards the service provider network. An interesting example we have seen in South Asia, in one of the largest LTE service providers in Asia. Unfortunately, I cannot name the customer, But within like few months of LTE launch, they were able to ramp up from around 80 million of subscribers towards, they are going towards 200 million of new subscribers getting predicted to add on towards the next year. And this not only means just added to that is the video, mobile video rate, right? A lot of subscribers want everything on mobile anytime, anywhere. So it really depends on what service provider network we are really looking at. What they have to plan for, they have to plan for a CGNAT kind of solution, which is able to support higher NAT session capacity, especially concurrent connections. Higher CCS is a must, is essential in order to support these type of traffic growth rates. So I may not have answered exactly straight to the point to your question, but it really depends on which region we are looking at and what type of service provider. Is it a mobile service provider or is it a cable operator with lot of cable service subscribers adding to their network? It really depends.
Great. I hope that answered your question. If we have any other questions, please submit them through the chat window. Otherwise, thank you for joining the A10's CGN webinar. Any unanswered questions sent during will be replied to via email after the webinar. Oh, I'm sorry, we have one more coming in. It says, thank you, yes, if there is a customer growth that will increase your traffic levels, but as there is move to IPv6 content, would there be less need for CGN?
Right. So, yes, with IPv6, if the service provider is transitioning completely towards an IPv6-based network, and if there is increasingly more IPv6 content, there will not be a need for CGNAT. But having said that, there are lots of content providers out there who are still IPv4 only, and there is definitely a need for translation, tunneling, and interplay between IPv4 and V6 networks. So it's a mix. I mean, as I said before, it's really impractical for a service provider to completely go with IPv6 network because all the content providers, the smartphone manufacturers, have to support IPv6 on their devices as well. We have been seeing an increasingly upward trend towards IPv6 networks and adoption of IPv6, but there is still a long time to go.
Great. Thank you again, Lakshmi. And I want to thank everyone for joining the call. Any unanswered questions sent during the webinar will be replied to via email after the webinar. And we will be offering this webinar on demand, and the recording will be sent after the webinar. Thank you again, and have a great day.